Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I would like to share with you my work hours and my job duties at the USPS. And before anything else, I just want to say to everyone that is watching this video that all I'm gonna share with you guys are all based on my experience, nothing more. And I'm gonna try to answer all your questions if I know the answer and the best that I can. As long as I know it, I would love to help you guys. So if you have any question, just don't hesitate to comment down below and I will get back to you whenever I get a chance. So without any further ado, let's get started. So guys, I've mentioned before that I just started working at the USPS and it's been over a month now. And since I started working, I have been getting 8 to 10 hours a day and 6 days a week. So my schedule right now has been pretty consistent. I do not know if it's gonna be the same after Christmas. I mean, after December, I will keep you updated. But so far, it has been good. For some people, they might not like that they have to work 6 days a week. I don't mind, and 8 to 10 hours a day, that's fine with me. You know, sometimes I work 9 hours. It just really depends how much packages. So yeah, I've heard that on December we might have to work more hours, so we'll see. So guys, as far as my job duties at the USPS, whatever I'm gonna share with you guys, it's all based on my experiences and it might be different at other locations. So I just wanna warn you that it's not gonna be the same. And I have been working in this location for a little bit over a month now. I haven't worked at the other location. Some of the people that I know, they moved them around in different locations. So I'm kinda glad that I'm staying at the same location because I'm able to focus on what I'm doing and learn more things without, you know, getting confused. Because every time you move to another location, they have different ways how to do things, so it's hard to focus. But anyways, I always start at 4 o'clock in the morning. My time has been pretty consistent since I started working. I start 4 o'clock in the morning, but if I work on Sundays, I start a little bit later. I start around 5:30 or 6 o'clock in the morning. But yeah, but when I get to work, I use my time card. That's what I use to check in. At the USPS, we use the word begin tour. So that's what I press. I press BT and then I would put my operation. Each operations at the USPS, there is a code for that. So that's what you use. So they have a code for moving, for scanning packages, P.O. boxes. See, I like, you know, when you're taking your lunch and after you get done working, you know, like end tour, they call it. Like if you check out, that is end tour. So when you check in, it's begin tour. When you check out, it's end tour. Yeah. So when I first get there, I would put the code, you know, moving, which is I will move stuff. So they have a code for that. And then I will go to the dock, get all the stuff that the truck brings us, like the packages, flats, letters, and all that. I will bring them inside and I will start scanning packages. So it depends how much packages. Sometimes we start at 4 o'clock in the morning and then we get done at 7:30. Lately we've been getting a lot of packages, so we get done around 8 to 8:30. The carriers get there around 7:30. So yeah, we scan the packages and then we put them to their designated routes, and the carriers will pick them up and get ready to be delivered. And before that, I sometimes help arrange the DPS. I think those contains letters. And after I scan all the packages, I will use my time card again and I would press MV, that means move, to another operation, which is accountable card. So the accountable card, it contains the registered mails, express packages or mails, their keys, and their gas cards. So I have to give those stuff to each carrier before they leave. That way they have their key, they have their gas cards, and you know, the important express mail. And those express mail, you have to write the tracking number, the express mail and express packages, and also how many registered mails, not registered mails, certified mails, certified and registered mails, I believe. So yeah, and then they're gonna sign for it, and yeah, that's it. After that, I'm gonna make another move and go to the P.O. boxes. The P.O. boxes, USPS has P.O. boxes for rent, and people rent them. So I would go there, I will put the code for P.O. boxes. While operation, they have a code for that. So at the P.O. boxes, I would put mails, letters, flats, like newspaper, whatever, you know, advertisement that they get, and whatever that fits in their box, whatever package that will fit there. So I put it over there. And after that, I will make another move, and I'll put the code for clean up. Like, you know, if you're moving stuff or putting all the stuff together, all the hampers, all the buckets and everything. Yeah, and after that, I will take my lunch around 11 o'clock, 10:30, it depends. After I take my lunch, oh, before that, before I do the accountable card, sometimes I will take my 15-minute break, because you'll get 2 15-minute break if you're working 8 hours to 10 hours. Anyways, after my lunch, I will go to the dock and get all the packages that the truck delivers. Usually, the DHL, UPS, and Innovations delivers package, the delivered packages, and then we are gonna scan those packages for the next day. Not for that day, because the carriers already left, so we have to scan those packages for the next day. So it's very important that you put in the computer that those packages are going for the next day, because if you put it for that for today, then those packages are gonna be out today. Because once the customer truck the package, it's gonna show that it's out for delivery today. Okay, so I think that's it. That's all I can remember. I'm gonna update you guys if I will know more information. I will try to help you guys. So if you have any question, don't hesitate to ask me. You can comment down below. As long as I know the answer, I will be glad to help you guys. So yeah, I think that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching my video, and also thank you so much to those who just subscribed to my channel. Please don't forget to like, comment, and share my video. And that's it. See you guys again for my next video. I hope you have a wonderful day, and advance happy Thanksgiving. Bye.